Kumar. You are watching Pani HS Info YouTube channel. I am here today to talk about scaffolding. What is a scaffolding? The term scaffolding is generally used for the temporary structure used for supporting the workmen during the construction. The construction of brickwork, plastering and painting or renewal or repairing of structures, etc. What are the materials used for scaffolding? Tubes or pipes, right angle coupler, swivel coupler, putla coupler, sleeve, planks, screw extension, ladders, ladder beam and sole board and base plate are the common materials used for erecting a scaffold. What is a scaff tag or scaffolding tag? There are three types of scaff tags or scaffolding tags are to be used. This one is red tag. This tag means the scaffolding is under erection, so do not use the scaffold. This is a green tag. This tag means scaffold is ready to use. And this is yellow tag. This tag indicates the damage of scaffold. What are the main parts of scaffolds? Base plate or sole plate. Plates on the ground supporting standards. Standards, the vertical ports are also called uprights. Ledger, the horizontal members parallel to the wall. Braces, the bracing system. Putlocks, horizontal members normal to the wall. Transoms, putlocks whose both ends are supported on the ledges in double scaffolding. Boarding, planks on which workmen stand. Guardrail, rail provided at 1 meter level to guard the men working. Toe board, boards placed parallel to the boarding near the wall to give protection to the workers and equipments. Ladder, access to reach the scaffolding platform. Types of scaffoldings. There are mainly four types of scaffoldings being used. First one is independent tight scaffolds. Second one, birdcage scaffold. Third one, tower scaffolds. And fourth one, putla scaffold. What are the scaffolding hazards? There are four major scaffolding hazards. First one, electrical hazards, working near energized or exposed electrical lines, using electrical power tools and welding equipment on scaffold. Second one, fall hazard. Third one, falling objects. And fourth one, scaffold instability or collapse. Safety while erecting or dismantling scaffolding. Only competent individuals may erect, maintain and dismantle the scaffold and inspect it daily when in use. Safe access must be provided. Set up a safe distance from power lines and other uninsulated electrical conductors. Make sure planks, decks, tow boards and guardrails are in place and secure. Use proper fall protection. Do not mix scaffolding components from multiple manufacturers. Level and erect the scaffold on a firm foundation with a wood, concrete or metal sill to ensure stability. Anchor scaffold vertically at no more than 4 meter intervals and horizontally at no more than 6 meter. Install cross bracing at all levels and make sure locking devices and ties are secure. How to inspect a scaffold? Scaffold must be inspected by a competent person for damage, deterioration and missing parts. Inspect before you allow to use them and before each ship. Inspect after any occurrence that may affect the stability or safe use of scaffolding. Check the condition of equipment, tubes, fittings, boards, ladders, etc. Check the condition of the handrails and tow boards are installed on the open ends. Check the ladders or stairways are provided for entry. Safety instructions while using scaffolding. Use a hoist or rope to move materials to upper levels. Do not carry materials when climbing scaffolding. Do not allow tools, materials or debris, example grease, dirt, snow, ice, to accumulate on the platform. Do not overload the scaffolding with too many people or materials in any one area. Make sure there is a safe entrance to all working levels. Barricade areas below there is a chance of items falling from the scaffolding. Never work on a scaffolding during storms or high winds. Thanks for watching Funny EHS Info. For any questions, please text me in comments. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you and have a safe day.